Hello everyone and welcome back to Doom the Astute, or at least the Doom aficionados among you probably recognize that this Tower of Babel here is the last level of this particular chapter of Doom. It's going to be a hopefully brief but helpful fight. Now in all of these there is some help in the form of rocket launchers, and now all we have to do is run around. I don't know if we have to defeat these in order to end the level, but we do have to defeat the Cyber Demon, which is the end boss of this particular part of Doom, and always has been, and evermore will be. Now, the Cyber Demon was the final boss of Doom 3, but it's not the final boss of this Doom. Although, in this Doom, all it does is shoot reasonably easily dodgeable rockets at you. Although, it would be nice if... Yeah, shoot it with a... That's going to help. Shotgun the Cyber Demon to death is a great idea. I mean, you can dance between the rockets, but so can it. In fact, it finds it reasonably easy to dance between your rockets, which is strange, because you'd think that something that big wouldn't be small enough to get in between those rockets, but, you know. All things surprise us in many ways. Even huge robot demon monstrosities like this one. Because you can sort of shoot it like this and try and dodge between these. Now there is a soul sphere over there somewhere. See how it could just apparently move really fast? It's strange. There is a soul sphere in at least one of these, this one. So if we go below 100 health, we might as well pick it up. If I mess up basically by doing that again. And you can't get back into the thing in the middle, but that doesn't really matter. I think we picked up the armor, but again, okay, so yeah, two soul spheres. So we basically can't die at all in this reasonably easy level. And I'm shooting these just because if they get in front of my rockets, I'm going to be mildly salty. And then basically just pump this thing full of rockets, or indeed plasma cells if we really choose to. But we can get back in the middle because this one's still open. Because if you open two of them, but only go through one of them, the other one remains open. Not sure why you would do it that way. Maybe it's a limitation of the already fairly limited, as we've discussed, scripting engine of the original Doom. Also, the auto-aim is kind of annoying, but I just generally don't know if you can turn it off. Look at the expression on his face there. Now he's pretty pissed off. He's like, I'm gonna push through the pain that you've caused me. Despite everything. Here we go. I appreciate this thing having... Ooh, careful. Got out of the tiny little cubby hole it found itself. Okay. So, in the last episode, I talked about how I changed from OBS Out Classic to OBS Studio. Oh, there we go. We've done it. And I was going, apologies for the quality. It turns out all the videos have been that bad quality, and I haven't noticed. You've done it. The hideous Cyber Demon Lord that ruled the lost Deimos moonbase has been slain, and you are triumphant, but where are you? You clamber to the edge of the moon and look down to see the awful truth. Deimos floats above hell itself. It does. I've been there. You've never heard of anyone escaping from hell, but you'll make the bastards sorry they ever heard of you. Which, you know, I mean, you'd think that if someone sort of wandered into your domain like this, you probably wouldn't have heard of him until he came to bring you down. Quickly, you rappel down to the surface of hell, which you can do in this game, even though you haven't had a grappling hook all this time. Now it's on to the final chapter of Doom, Inferno. So, yeah, that was a very small, quick episode. No, we'll continue this episode, or 4 minutes of it, with a new game into Inferno. Now, Thy Flesh Consumed is the fourth one that is introduced in Ultra Doom. Oh, I remember this level. Ultimate Doom, not Ultra Doom. And I'm pretty sure we get several weapons in this particular level, which is quite small, so it's not too bad. But we also get a few cacodemons, fun times for everybody involved. So here's one of the things I'm hoping to be fixed in Doom 2016. This opens up into an entire chamber. Yep, there we go. I'm pretty sure there is a shotgun in this bit. Or am I wrong? I mean, we didn't start with our chainsaw. That's kind of... I mean, I mentioned this before, but whenever you go into the new section of the... when you go to a new chapter, you don't have any of the stuff that you ended the last chapter with. Now, I'm supposed to believe that I've just rappelled down into the surface of hell and started in a hole with a button in it. Yes. There's a lot of suspension of disbelief. I'm looking forward to the new game, because obviously in Doom 3, I got hit, apparently. No. Aha. In Doom 3, it puts a lot more focus on the continuity of the game. Everything moves, and it's not so that's separated into chapters, which is, I suppose, a large part of it, but there's a lot more focus on this whole idea of continuity between the chapters of the levels of the game. Again, there's not even levels, it's just... nope, our pistol is too... it's just... I kind of want to go this way, but... You know, it is separated into levels, but it's separated naturally by elevators and things, not by... buttons. But don't really do it. So I'm going to go over here and see if there's a secret. There isn't, and this hurts like shit. But no, it's worth a look. We've been down to 3% health before and rallied from it, so I don't think we need to worry too much. See, I left the previous chapter with all those weapons that popped in the BFG, unfortunately, and, you know, more than 100% health. Quite a lot of armor, even though I exploded myself a few times. Oh, there you go, perfect. And we started this one with nothing at all. Like, it's been just removed from us for being... Like, it's been confiscated, right? I don't want my stuff to be confiscated just because I have decided to go into hell. That's just silly. And yeah, the way that none of this is visible from the start of the level is just a function of the primitive engine. But it's not that primitive. It's not as primitive as Wolfenstein. So this looks odd. Now, this whole level has been slightly backwards, I guess you'd say. Like, it all seems very odd. And I think that's part of the point. It's supposed to evoke this sort of... keep calling it a manic descent into hell. You know, the doors are upside down, the pools are filled with blood and that sort of thing. But now we're in hell itself, so... We're not really expecting to see any more, please, any more technology, basically. What a strange level. It's just the first level, and I'm fairly sure this is not the end of it, but it could be. Take all this. It's whatever. We didn't get any secrets. There may not have been any secrets. So we'll just keep going. Sloth of Despair. So we've come down these steps, fine. I understand that. And I ain't even mad that we can't go back up them. I mean, wouldn't you just have a line which, when crossed, exits the level? I mean, you do. It's the teleporter. It's pretty much exactly what it does. In fact, I'm fairly sure it's literally what it does. You cross that line and you exit the level. I don't really want to use my ammo on that thing. Would like to find a chainsaw or something. Ah, oh, you're invisible. No wonder I can't see you. So why not make that line, like, the start of these stairs? Instead of a teleporter. It's possible that they just hadn't thought of that. You know, that's a... it's almost what you want to call an advanced level... game design technique is to join things together using things that you would not necessarily have used. Now, it's possible that what you have to do is create a sector, but again, the sector doesn't have to be square. It could literally have been anything. So you could have made the top of them steps. Everything that we've done so far in Doom has been press button or jump on teleporter to end level. When you enter the next level, it has nothing to do with the end of the previous one. So, again, I think that's more from a, I want to say an immature, and I don't mean that in a childish way, I mean that in a early game development sort of way. Early industry of game development sort of way. This is going to be good. This will help us get away with quite a lot of... stuff that we otherwise couldn't have gotten away with because we need ammo, we don't have any. I'm still not quite sure when the Berserk runs out, nor what the effect is of Berserk. I think you just have damage commensurate with the amount of red the screen has in your punch. Don't waste ammo like that, if you can possibly help it. Alright, we can't get in there yet. Oh well, we just jump across that and now we can. Alright, sweet. So we have a secret chain gun, which is fine with me. I mean, we had a bit more of it in Hexen, where... first of all, a lot of the transitions between levels just involved running through those... the portals, the ethereal travel portals, not that we have the time between loading to actually read the words ethereal travel, now that computers are about four times as fast as the Hexen developers ever expected them to be. Four times, that seems... actually probably underselling the power of these computers, but okay. Yeah, it's basically no time at all in the loading now. But those ethereal travel portals were at least a nice idea. I seem to have accidentally released way more hounds than I intended to right here. Doing okay on ammo though, we did manage to save a little bit whilst gaining some as a result of punching ammunition dropping enemies the heck to death. Noticing, again, as I said, I'm noticing more about the intentions of the original game designers, where the first time I played the game, I was just going, oh, look, things to shoot them. I can't help but notice that there's a whole bunch of, well, apart from these heads, these flying skulls, there's a whole bunch of human, or previously human, things down here, which means... other people have been brought down to hell and zombified, or vice versa. Are you attacking each other? You can definitely attack each other, I'm okay with that. Picked up a stimpack. I'm noticing occasional messages and I'm wondering what the heck they're saying. And turns out I've taken a small amount of damage and not noticed myself healing from it. We'll just clear this out as best we can. Probably want to use our bullets. Having these things flinch is... very useful. That was great. How much damage did that do? Ridiculous. This is fun. Thanks for lining up like this. Our punch is amazing, by the way. Even though our berserker's worn off. You've seen this. We're two-shotting them. It makes it about as strong as a shotgun. All shells. Yeah, you just do that for a while. I'm okay with it. Wish I could pick these up. It's possible that there's something that lowers these. We're trapped in here. That's interesting. I assume that there's something that lowers these, and I vaguely remember that there is something that lowers these. But yeah, I'd definitely like to have more than 10 shells to beat this cacodemon with. Because undoubtedly there's something even worse around the corner. It takes 6 full shells of damage. Does this do anything? No. Yikes. You may have noticed I just ran the heck away. It's because I have 4 shells left and it takes 6. So I'm going to have to punch it a couple of times, which means I would like to... I'll have taken any damage I don't need to take. Yeah, so 2 more punches. And we're in... we're in Kill the Cacodemon territory, so... it's definitely true that one of these punches is as good as one of those punches. By which I mean one actual punch is as good as one shotgun. That is HP, which is gradly. Don't get me wrong. But I'd much more prefer to have had a... ammunition of some description. These glows, by the way, would never have existed in the original Engine of Doom. That took 3. I assume they don't have a random amount of health, so it's possible that I get a random damage from a range per punch rather than... No. We're doing fine. Save your ammo for now, because something's going to show up that's really going to require it. So I'm supposed to press that one, so I don't know what happens if I press that one. Or I'm not supposed to press that one, because it's hell, and hell is full of traps and twickery. Maybe just go into a different one. Okay, so we can't see through there, and that's the blue door. Weird-ass hell caves contain caches of ammo. So it's we're not the first person to have done this. I think this is what they're trying to get across here, which is interesting because, again, there's no way I would have noticed this when I first played the game. Do you see that arrow on the map there? That's what we like to see. That's a very 90s thing to do. So let's see. There is... Turn follow mode off and go in here. There's an arrow there which opens that up. So I'm guessing the other one, which doesn't have the arrow on it, lowers those things. Because I'm pretty sure something lowers those things. But we'll press this one for now and open up this. Get a soul sphere. And this one probably opens up that, which we knew was there because of the map. I'm going to continue to conserve my ammo because I have some vague recollections of what sorts of horrible things there are waiting for me in the next few levels. So we've got the blue key. We press both of these, that's fine. I mean, it didn't need to tell me which one to press because I was going to press them both. And it actually was beneficial for me to have pressed the second one as well as the first one. I mean, there's ammo up here. So it seems silly to suggest that I wouldn't be able to get up here. Not that. Can I just press it? No, I can hump it. So there's that. Let's see. Missing a switch somewhere, no doubt. Are you seeing this, this line here? What the heck is that? See, now I'm trying to... like, wall hack the map. Why aren't we... There we go. Oh, it tells me how many secrets I found. 3 of 3. Killed all the monsters, too. I mean, it's not the end of the world, but I'd like to get that many... I'd like to get that many shotguns if I can, because it would probably get me very close to full. Not this one. Yeah, it's very unlikely that I would have realised what they were telling me in this, which is that other people have been down here and become zombified. Because that would, you know, especially in an early game like this, that would be fairly... Ah, there we go. You can actually get into that one by running. That'll be a bit dissuasive, I guess you might say. 66% items. I wonder which one I missed. I picked up the Soul Sphere. We'll see how far we get through Pandemonium. I think this is the one with... Oh, I quite like the design of this level, actually. It reminds me a lot of future versions of the same game. It's a very nostalgic level as well, but it's very intricate. It's an intricate design. So we have severely hampered our ability to punch, which kind of implies that Berserk didn't wear off. Do you not think? So there may actually be a bug in Berserk there, and I may have cheesed it and not realised. 4 entrances to this. Now, Pandemonium is an actual real thing. I don't know if it's from the Bible, but it's definitely part of one culture's version of hell, is that there's this place called Pandemonium. It may actually be the name for hell. I'm working off half-baked information that I'm vaguely remembering, having realised that at some point I heard it. Whereas now we use it to mean... general chaos, right? You hearing that noise? Did I put the dishwasher on? I think I might have put the dishwasher on. It's mildly scary, especially playing a game like this, which is still a bit of a Twitch shooter even now. Mildly terrifying. I remember this bit with all the blood and gore and stuff on the thing. Mildly terrifying having noises in the background that you can't identify. Especially when you'll know that you're likely to be nommed on by an invisible enemy. I shouldn't really be too worried, because of course, with modern gaming practices, it should be reasonably easy to recover from any mistakes. I mean, all of these are creepy and everything, but this bit hurts, so let's not stay there. I like that. I like the way you can see why it's called Pandemonium. Everything is bizarre and broken and twisted. And they've managed to achieve this without any real overlap. Well, any at all overlap in layers, you know? There's nothing here that is overlapping anything else, and yet we've got a lot of Z-axis work. I remember this level being very interesting for that reason. It's all laid out perfectly flat until you go in it and see how up and down he is. And it's very tight as well, very cramped. How about you? I'm reasonably sure this... Well, apparently this is a secret. Oh, Jesus. Help. What have I done? Oh, jeez, there you are. Yeah, as I was saying, modern gaming techniques with mouse and keyboard, basically, should somewhat insulate me from any horrible mistakes I made. I mean, we've seen the fact that when I ran into a room full of skulls and got down to 3% health, I somehow managed to come back from it just by not dying. Apologies for the loudness. Making them flinch is really helpful. Anything that can shoot you needs to flinch, which is why chain gun versus demons is obviously going to win. Which is why I'm not too worried about a real hell invasion, because humanity has got chain guns. There is invincibility here, which is interesting, and I'm not going to take it just yet, because unlike, you know, previous me, modern me knows exactly how to save advantages. Although it might be valuable here. Not sure. Well, we can use it and see what happens.
Invulnerability.
Oh yeah, don't forget that chap's going to shout at us and scare everybody. So we'll see if there's anything in here.
Soulsphere.
There is, that's nice. So now we're basically... We're invincible and we have so much health that even if we did get hit, it wouldn't matter. We just now need to run around as much as we possibly can. Until, invincibility wears off because we want to... But you know what, we should be... Oh. I was going to say we should be punching things, but invincibility, probably for balance reasons, doesn't last that long. It's a very strange concept, invincibility, but I really do hope that they bring it back for Doom 2016, because you know, there's no reason to have removed... I mean, it's an arcadey thing, and I'm completely aware of that, don't get me wrong. I know this opens. I can't remember how. I mean, these look like switches, right? So you're pressing. Can I pick that up? No. Okay. It doesn't. Okay. Screw me, I guess. They have butts. It's an arcadey thing, and I'm hoping that Doom 2016 brings back the arcadey feel of Doom. And I know I was saying in the previous episode that the almost seriousness of Doom 3 was pleasing. I felt that a refresh of the whole concept of Doom in a modern style, a modern aesthetic, and a modern understanding of how to make cheap jump scares was worthwhile. Just use this shit. In burning. Get dusted. Trouble is with these particular weapons is that you end up taking longer killing them because you don't want to waste the ammo. So in this game, obviously, they've just used lots of tricks and techniques to do strange things and called it Pandemonium, which makes perfectly good sense. But they haven't done anything terrifying. Maybe it was terrifying at the time. And then in Doom 3, a lot of what I liked about it was the fact that it was telling a story visually. It had a lot of actual things that actually look like what they're actually meant to be, And it wasn't arcadey. I think that was... How is this a secret? Point was that it was not arcadey. Now that says poison but looks like water. I think that's part of the theme of this level. It was a real game with real models and real level designs. I'm, again, not trying to shit on level design of these previous game developers, because obviously they have made a perfectly sensible level, one of which is, like, good enough that I nostalgically recognize it and still think it's a really good level design, especially using the limits they had. But also think that we can get away with expecting better stuff from Doom 2016 and allow it to have this arcadey feel where you still run around having things like invincibility. They did have, for example, a Berserk in Doom 3, and I've mentioned it before, and it was great. I really liked it. It had a really good arcadey feel to it, because it was just this thing, and you scream like a mofo and punch the crap out of everything around you. Ow. But it kind of fitted in to the theme of Doom 3. Because it's hard to describe why I think that, actually. I just do. So let's see if... obviously Berserker's worn off. Pretty sure we're still shotgunning these things. I don't remember what the Berserk thing looked like in Doom 3. I don't remember what the pickup looked like. Fairly sure it was just an emblem of some sort floating in... just on the ground. I remember the effect it had, and it was really, really... what's the word I'm looking for? Like, very evocative of what it was really doing, which was just making you berserk. But it didn't have any... It didn't tie itself to the game. So when I say it fitted in, I meant that the style of it fitted in. But in a game like this, you have lots of just individual things that you pick up and do things with. You know, it's just a collection. What did I pick up? A clip. It's a collection of pickups and effects and arcadey type things like that. Whereas in Doom 3, they tried to make it a serious game. Nevertheless, they still had to put in that arcadey type Berserk thing, which... honestly, it didn't really fit. We'll jump into this exit, and presumably that's the end of the level. It is. And I think I'll call that the end of that episode. That was quite a long episode compared to all the others, but thank you for watching it. I didn't find all the secrets. Maybe I'm not going to find the secret level on this chapter, because honestly, I don't know where it is. But yes, thank you for watching this episode. I hope that you're enjoying it. Remember, subscribing helps you, and liking the video helps us. Go and check out other people's videos. Ed at some point will be starting to upload videos, and James is playing Hollow Knight, which looks like a really cool little platform game, very arcade, again, style. We play a lot of arcadey games on this channel, but yes, looking forward to Doom 2016, and looking forward to the next episode, so I hope to see you then.